My talk would be nanotechnologies in precision farming. That's my talk. And why nanotechnology? I have not studied nanotechnology in agriculture course, even horticulture or any of the undergraduate program. I have not studied nanotechnology. I understand, I learned myself nanotechnology only by accident. In the year 2008, somewhere in 2008, there was a call for a special project. The project which is not known, that type of project they called for 20 crore. I proposed nanotechnology is one of my area of research. So that's the way I came. And the learning lesson from nanotechnology is none other than from Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. He was president at that time. And he motivated me to choose nanotechnology in agriculture. So at that time, I did not get a grant, but I got lots of learning experience with nanotechnology. Now, within 10 years of existence, as Dr. Raghuraman indicated, I got about 30 crore. And the university, I am ranking number one in terms of number of grants received. So that is the background in which I start. How nanotechnology came to TNIU? This is a picture I used to say. 1909 is a year in which TNIU started. Exactly 100 years, we became nanotechnologists. Nanotechnology started. So why nanotechnology in agriculture? I always say this particular picture to show we are changing the scenario of agriculture. These are the traditional farming practice like plowing, begging type of farmers and all. Now the farmers in Tamil Nadu is totally different. So they want to get it done by mobile. They want to get it done with drones spray in the field. And that type of transformation they would expect. So in simpler term, the definition of nanotechnology is atomic manipulation. The principles and practices in nanotechnology applied to agriculture become nano-agriculture. So this is what I'm talking about, how it can be done. So for a better understanding of nano is very, very small. Very, very small, but very, very smart as well. So I put this picture, I think all of you have seen this picture. You are seeing Indian map. India is one of the most populous country in the world next to China. At this moment, a few minutes ago, I just picked up this number, 1.398 billion people in this country. 140 crore people are living in this country. Imagine the entire population of India zipped into 1 meter length, each Indian is become a nano-sized particle. So the size becomes very small, it becomes very smart. So for a simpler understanding, nano is very small. Nano is 1 billionth of a meter or 1 in 100 crore, typically India population. So when you do the size reduction, you can increase the surface area. This is the typical example how it is done. So a cube is a cube which has 6 sides in it. When it undergoes the division for 24 times, it becomes a nano-sized particle. When a cube is as a macro material, it becomes only 120 meters square or so. When it is divided into 24 times, it becomes a nano-sized particle. You can spread the entire football stadium with one simple meter, a simple cube of macro material. So now we understand how it is important. Atom by atom manipulation, we call it as a nanotechnology. So this morning, everybody talking about nanotechnology. Agriculture Production Commissioner very frequently referred to nanotechnology, even Director Horticulture, Director Agriculture. Everybody speaks of nanotechnology. That's why this particular topic is assigned here. Then this is the growth of nanotechnology in the country, in the world. In the world, the nanotechnology investment has gone up from $1 billion in 2000. Now it is $3 trillion, 3,000 times increase in a period of 20 years. And this is the way the nanotechnology shaped up in the country. In the 11th five-year plan, 1,000 crore were invested. In the 12th five-year plan, 2,000 crore were invested. Only a few projects recommended in agriculture. The 11th five-year plan, only one project was accepted by Nano Mission, that was TNIU. Again, in 12th five-year plan, we got two or three projects in the two from TNIU only. So the major investment, this is the gap between what is there in the country, 1,000 crore, 2,000 crore. Yeah, university, which is very little, though I have 30 crore worth of project, So yes, still it is, you know, it is just the ground. This particular picture impressed then the Prime Minister of India, Manmohan Singh, liked this particular picture very much. Because when country has 800 million people depend on agriculture, why this investment is so, you know, close to the ground? That was very impressive. That is why I started, you know, started getting lots of grant. So where exactly nanotechnology can be applied? And you can also interact with me at any point of time. And all of you listening to me or not? Can somebody say yes? Yes or no? It is muted. Okay.
Yes.
So I am sure all of you listen to me. There are four areas in which nanotechnology can be applied in agriculture. First is a timely detection of nutrient deficiency, pests and diseases. You know, in agriculture, we have got a wide range of entomologists always start with, you know, insects. So many insects they will teach, but none of the insects appear in the field now. Now we have got invasive pests, which we were not taught, you know, at undergraduate level. So we have so many pests and diseases, nutrient deficiency, we have to detect them. Timely detection is essential. The smart delivery of input, we need to deliver the way it should be done. What is the amount of nutrients taken by crops only to be applied? If you take 100 kg of nitrogen, plant is going to take only 20 kilos, 30 kilos. 70 kg is going as waste. Instead of going with that, with the nanotechnology, we can make, we are going to see some of the nano products, which is close to 90% use efficiency. We have got the post-torus technology, which is also, we have lots of nano products there, and the safety of nano products. So these are the four areas I'm going to speak now. First is the nano diagnostic. Diagnostic is number one priority in Indian agriculture. Tamil Nadu agriculture and agriculture officers, diagnostic is the number one priority for you. And agri subject is always, I say that agriculture is a subject of confusion. You confuse a lot, you learn a lot of confused things, and you make sure that the farmers get confused. Typically, if you, I may be the director of research, if you take an example of TNAU, how many farmers visit to TNAU every day? Very limited. If you look at other side, if you take a medicos, there are, we are in Coimbatore, there are many hospitals. Doctors are flooded with hospitals. Now COVID-19, there is lots of, you know, hundreds of thousands of patients are going to the hospital, get the advice of the doctor. But if you look at agriculture, which is also very important subject of interest, you know, common livelihood for the people, but never visit because it's confused. We don't give the correct information. So what we are trying to do in nanotechnology, the moment a farmer comes here, he will be served with this type of product. So the first and foremost is on-site detection of leaf moisture, wherein we touch the plant, plant will tell exactly what is the moisture content. So what we do, we measure the electrical conductance of the leaf in vis-a-vis the moisture content of the leaf. So that is a direct relationship. So basically we measure the electricity of the leaf is to measure the moisture content. What we are trying to do, this product is developed in one of my project only. So this product, we are adding further to this. If this product is attached to the leaf, you will get SMS, you know, the plant will need water. Plant will send a SMS to the farmer saying that I need water. So that type of product we are developing in nanotechnology. It's a very important one. There is another product we develop is the nitrogen content of the leaf. The nitrogen content, you all know, nitrogen is a very critical element for agriculture. Most of the soils in India is deficient in nitrogen. Nitrogen application becomes very universal, and every crop cultivated in India or Tamil Nadu, nitrogen fertilizer supplied. So what we do in this particular device, we develop a small stapler-like thing. We attach to the leaf, a light is passed through that. It is like a LED light. LED light passed through the leaf, and the conductance is measured. Instantly, we will know what is the nitrogen content. So earlier slide, I show you how the moisture content is measured. Now the nitrogen content is measured. If this type of product is developed for an agriculture officer, if you want a farmer, if you go to the field and he says whether the nitrogen to be applied or irrigation to be given, you have to touch and the plant will tell exactly what is there and what to be given. So this type of product we develop in nanotechnology. It is in the development stage, but there are some products which I am going to show you later. They are in the field level. Then there is another equally like entomologists, the pathologists are very, very difficult guys to handle, because pathologists give descendants. When we joined TNAU, we had a vice chancellor, Dr. S. Jayaraj. He always say that pathologists are the killers of the university, because they give a death sentence, cut and burn type of recommendation. You cannot give any more. We need to be very precise in detecting that. See, you look at the medicos. Medicos are very, medicos also commit mistakes, but medicos in general, they are very precise. They precisely say, when the temperature rises to this level, or oxygen going down, you have COVID. Very precisely they that. And they will also anticipate another 14 days time, you're going to be dispatched or going to be discharged to home or something like that. But in agriculture, we don't do that. And we are the guys known for passing the ball to one to other. Entomologist says nematology, nematology pathology, pathology says soil scientist. That is why farmers are not coming to TNAU, because we confuse the people as much as we can, because our subject is very complex and we get confused. And these are the nano-based product will help you to understand the subject better for KVKs, for agriculture officer, and this is what we want to do. This is an important product where we can detect the disease on spot, wherein we take the leaf, squeeze the leaf, a drop of leaf cell comes out, that is percolated into the nanomatrix, and the nanomatrix react to the leaf cell, and immediately you get the signal saying that yes and no type of reaction. So it is typically like a pregnancy kit, where a few drops of urine is enough to detect the disease, detect the pregnancy. So do COVID-19. Some advancement is being done. Instead of RT-PCR, you can go with different types of tests could be done. People are interested, that type of detection device, they are interested. Here in the virus detection is done for pungitopa virus in banana, where a strip of, the nano strip is dipped into the leaf sap, and you get a color change. If the two bands are appearing, which means there is a presence of pungitopa virus. If it is not appearing, which means you are free from there. Within 1 minute, you will know what is happening. If this type of devices are developed, certainly our officers will not confuse the farmer. Farmer will be perfectly understanding what is happening. So this type of devices we want to develop. It is sensitive, rapid, less than light, cost effective, and so on. So these are in the development stage. There is another technology, is called e-nose technology, electronic nose technology. Electronic nose technology is simply like how exactly a sniffer dog detect the criminal. So that's what electronic nose technology. E-nose is an electronic nose where a small analyte can be assessed with the help of this device. So for example, I come from southern part of Tamil Nadu, Tuticorin district, where when a farmer had to buy a land, they simply plow the land, could the smell of the soil. Soil smell is an indication of health status of the soil. So one of the geosmin is one of the compound responsible for the flavor of the soil. The flavor of the soil could be a fertility status of the soil can be measured. So we are developing this type of devices. We simply get the volatile profile of the sample, and in turn we can do that. Same thing can be used for detecting the seed quality. Seed quality, some of the agriculture officers may be involved in seed testing laboratories, where we can also do the e-nose technology to detect the seed quality. The seeds are the prime source in agriculture. Seeds are very, very important, and we need to give the quality seed to the farmer. And when we put the this e-nose technology, it is in the development stage now, but we will do it in a few years' time. We will have this kind of a handheld device to identify what it is. So such an important device would can be done with the nanotechnology. So here the intervention is conventional technology. It takes long time to do. In nanotechnology, we can simply measure the volatile profile. In other case, we measure the analyte quickly and do the analysis in a very precise way. In that way, we can make the agriculture a very precise one. And there are other, closely, I think there is a devoted lecture on remote sensing, I suppose, and I don't want to disturb their lecture. But what is the thing I should say, that the remote sensing and the nanotechnology, sometimes it goes hand in hand in the name of smart farming. That's what Dr. Raghunaman saying, that and was talking about smart farming, where you don't need any type of persons involved here. It's only electronic gadgets to help you to understand irrigation to be given, or pest identification, or pesticide spray, and so on. And here, remote sensing department of TNAU has lots of laurels to say. They have responsible for tsunami time in 2004. They detected very precisely and the impact of flood in Chennai was detected precisely. Drought situation, floods, and recently the Kaja cyclone. Kaja cyclone happened somewhere in November 2018. In the Tanjore, Pattukote, and other area, where this remote sensing devices are, we send the drones for scanning the entire area. Within 2 days, we could make an assessment that how many palms have been affected. 38 lakh palms, 72,000, and have been affected. So with the help of a simple technology, we will be able to precisely know. If the Kaja cyclone happened, and if we do not have this technology, the people would have suffered a lot, because the Kaja cyclone really devastated lots of farms. 38 lakh farms is such a huge loss to those areas. Well, with the help of this drone technology, we have detected precisely. So maybe more information you get it from remote sensing lecture. And here, why I'm connecting here, most of the integration is done in digital devices. So we have most of your mobile has digital display as well, Intel chip, which can be loaded with this, so that you will know what is happening on the spot. You can detect what it is. So TNAU also helping the Department of Agriculture and Department of Horticulture in area detection, crop loss, crop insurance can be done with this. Digital mapping can be done, and recently we have found that it can be used for how much methane is comes out. One of the interesting product which we are going to launch by next month is a soil doctor. Soil doctor, it is a very simple device. It is like Arogya Setu. You heard of Arogya Setu? Whenever you want to locate somebody affected in this locality, COVID-19, immediately it will pop up in your mobile. If you are connected to that area, you will get it. You will get the information that somebody is infected. Likewise, this particular soil doctor, it is a device, has all the provision. Tamil Nadu has 85 lakh farm soil. If you do the traditional analysis, Dr. Raghuraman mentioned, I am a soil scientist, so I know how soil analysis is very important. So soil analysis is very complex. 85 lakh farm soils to be analyzed, it takes about 10 years. So what we have done here, all the data which is available is all zipped into this software, and we put a soil app. So you click on the mouse, we'll know. If you type your village name or farm name, you will instantly get the soil fertility status. Adding further to this, if you go to the field and you want to check the soil fertility, so immediately it will say this is the fertility status of the location in which you are standing. Suppose you are just for fun, if you want to fool off this device, if you test it in an auditorium where we stand now, and if you want to do it in your office, it will say it is a residential area. So that's a precise product we have got. We are going to launch very soon. So these are the emerging areas of interest. And we also have a drone technology. The drones are devices, pilotless vehicle. This vehicle can spray, do lots of jobs. It can be used for spraying pesticide, fungicides, and bioinoculant boosters, crop boosters, micronutrients, so on. And one drone, we have got a drone with TNAU. We also have the vehicle mounted with the drones. Drones can give a spray. 1 hectare of land can be sprayed in 5 minutes, 2 minutes per acre. That's the way it is done. 100 acres can be sprayed in one day. So such a very interesting technology that we have introduced. Why I am connecting here with the nanotechnology is that there is a need for nanotechnology here. So whatever the pesticide we have got in the market or agrochemicals that are available, It's all meant for regular spray. So we are reorienting to drone spray, which is not accepted. I think entomologists will not agree because they have ultra low volume spray to be given. So now we are in the process of developing such a molecules or nano products to give a spray like this. So these are the things we need to know. So I have shown you diagnostic devices. I have shown you Enos technology. I have shown you drone technology, how it can be used. Suppose we use all these technologies, certainly agriculture will grow very fast and we'll be respected. We will, people will look for you instead of getting away from you. And why agriculture, the smart delivery? We have another important technology. The seed is a prime input in agriculture. The seed, anything with the seed, any technology associated with the seed, 100% adoption is ensured. So we use a nanofiber technology where we take, it is a polymer is converted into a fiber, is a continuous thread coated on the seed. We can put the entire gamut of nutrients, inoculum for the seed, for the crop. So in this case, we have used the groundnut. So complete set of nutrients applied. It is a very interesting technology, but if I say something related to this technology, you'll be surprised that the technology is very simple. The nanofiber technology is as simple as that. It is a cotton candy technology. All of you are aware of Panjimutai, where a man adding polymer and sugar, and the machine keep on rolling, and it gives a fiber continuously. That we call it as a nanofiber technically. This nanofiber, the beauty of this technology is that the nanofiber can have the surface area of 1 gram of nanofiber is equal to 10,000 meters square. Roughly one hectare of land is loaded onto the seed. If you look at the length of the fiber, you can connect Coimbatore with Delhi, 2,000 kilometer length of the fiber in 1 gram. Such a beautiful technology. We started using it for nutrient delivery. We started using it for bioinoculant. Entire agriculture going in one. This type of agriculture, farmers are interested to hear, because you do everything at once and you don't need to go to the field anymore. Now the people going to the field is very, very limited. So nanofiber is very powerful. We can put bioinoculant, rhizobium, pseudomonas, phosphobacteria, whatever the inoculum you needed, you do that. So you get very good seedlings because of that. I also developed a nano fertilizer for groundnut. So that nano fertilizer is made of zeolite. Zeolite is a natural mineral which is there in Gujarat. And we take the mineral, it is like a clay mineral. It is converted into nano size and we put the sulfate loaded into that. It becomes a nano fertilizer. And by doing this fertilizer, the plants are growing very well. And what we have not done earlier, now what we are trying to do is that when the fertilizer is added, the plant is using only 18 to 20% sulfur. Phosphorus is 20%. Nitrogen goes up to 30%. Remaining goes somewhere. Now by doing this nanotechnology, we'll be able to achieve 90% use efficiency. That's what you do. You look at these plants. The plants are healthier. The sulfur content of the plant control versus treated, it is higher. We also look at the nodule, which is much denser nodules you could see in the nodules of the legume, which is very intense when nano fertilizer is added. So now we have studied nano nitrogen, nano sulfur and so on. Now we have moved to the next level. When you look at each and every nutrient, planets all the nutrients, particularly pulses. Pulses are poor man's crop, but rich man's diet is required. So it needs nitrogen, phosphorus, 18 nutrients are required. Can you apply 18 fertilizer independently? Now I thought that it can be used as a pellet. It's called a nanonutrients pellet. So we make as a nutri pellet. One pellet is 1 gram. 1 gram is enough for one plant. So that's the way we have come up with. We put everything together as a pellet. You put it at the time of sowing. You forget. You don't need to go to field anymore. When you harvest, you do that. I studied in Canada. That's the way Raghuraman introduced me. I studied in Canada. I visited northern part of Canada where the lands are plenty. I met one small farmer. He says he pretended to be a small farmer. I asked how many acres you have. He said 800 acres. 800 acres is considered as a small farmer in Canada. So for a large farmer, 2,500 acres per individual. The here the land holding is different. So that farmer, he has one machine. It has everything in it. I just to drive something. It has a fertilizer applicator. It has a GIS provision. It has a herbicide applicator. Everything attached to that. One time you go, apply everything. Next time you go only for harvest. No more in between you should go. So that type of agriculture is important for Indian agriculture. Because Indian agriculture, nobody, I could see, I have a list of ADA's agriculture officers. There are many comes from Western Zone. Western Zone farmers are very committed farmers. And now they are also moving towards cities and nobody care about agriculture. So we need this type of innovative product needed. And we also have a nano emulsion to reduce the moisture loss from the plant so that plant can survive better. It's called nano emulsion. And we also have the encapsulated form of Pseudomonas. Because the Pseudomonas are bioinoculants, they are all desiccating very fast. Because of the high temperature, it is desiccating very fast. But we do it in nanotechnology. We shield the bioinoculant with a protein called sericin protein. The sericin comes from silkworm. A silkworm after reeling, you get a waste material called sericin. So that material, we go, do that. Oh, somebody raised the hand. Yeah, please. What should I do? Yes. Yeah, yeah. Who raised? Can you introduce yourself? It's also breathing time for me. Yeah. Chalunga ma, what do you want to ask? Yaar? So far, everybody understand? ADA Alathur. ADA Alathur. ADA Alathur. You understand? DDFTC Trichy. All of you understand what I'm saying so far? ADA Thali. Sir, can you unmute and speak for a minute? And he seriously seeing the number of pages are located. ADA Alathur. Okay. Can you speak? ADA Alathur.
Sir, DDFTC Trichy, sir.
Okay. Yeah, do you understand so far? Okay. I'll complete and we'll come back to you. Okay.
Okay.
So the sericin, this is the bioinoculant. They all shielded with the sericin protein so that it can be protected. Another one, the viral diseases are very important for agriculture. After COVID-19, people are truly worried about plant viruses also. They're also equally dangerous. So what we try to do in this particular method, and we use nanosilica, and we identify certain molecule like anoscomozin. Anoscomozin is from the custard apple. Custard apple is sitapalam, in which you have a seed. Seed is loaded with, or seed has anoscomozin. That molecule is extracted and put it in silica, and we deliver to the plant so that you can control the vector. So the when vector in this particular case is Mysis persicae. If the stylet of Mysis persicae has a protein, this protein has to bind with the virus, then only virus get infected. So this is the way virus is transmitted. What we try to do in this method, we try to introduce nanosilica into the plant so that the molecule which we loaded into nanosilica, it is blocking the transmission of the virus. By doing that, we can effectively smother that. Maybe this technology can also be applied to COVID-19, where the only problem is COVID-19 has no vector. It is only your saliva is a vector, or your droplets are the vector. It's a zoonotic, which means man-to-man conduction. There is no vector involved in COVID-19. That's why it's very difficult to do that. So this type of technology we are developing and do that. There is another one. It is this technology is very popular. Nano nitrogen, nano zinc, and nano copper. And these are the product IFCO has developed. And it is broadcast across the country. And right now, KVK is working on 11,000 locations where these products are being tested at 11,000 locations. And I am very happy that TNAU is partnering in that. TNAU is part of the system as well. TNAU is helping, IFCO in deciding that. And the interesting background of this story would be, IFCO launched this product last Independence Day, when Prime Minister Modi came for the Independence Day and this product was launched. And these products, they projected as though we can help a lot, the farmers would be benefited. Then the ICR, Director General of ICR called me that how it can be helped, because Prime Minister opened up this particular business to the country. Certainly everybody, they cannot withdraw the decision of the Prime Minister. Certainly TNAU is involved in this process. Now we are validating this particular product. So the way in which IFFCO projected is that when the spray is given one or two times, entire fertilizer could be saved. That's the way they projected. When we look at this product, nano zinc, nano copper, nano iron and all, when it is sprayed, it is not that much effective, but it has at least 10 to 15% higher biomass or yield than the conventional one. So I am also involved in this process. Some of you would have known CIB, Central Insecticide Board. Likewise, there is a nano board. Nano products are being dealt. I'm one of the core committee members deciding on nano input for the country. So that's a great honor to us, honor to TNAU as well. So I think last but one is reducing the post-harvest losses. The problem with the Indian agriculture is we produce a lot. We produce everything excess. We produce excess in terms of population. We produce excess in terms of grains, fruits, vegetables. Everything is excess. If you look at production point of view, if you look at statistics, just a few minutes ago, I just want to copy the Indian population. The moment I have to copy, before that, four children were born. So that type of people we have. Of course, COVID-19, though it took the life of at least 7,000 people in Tamil Nadu, all over India, it's 48,000. Still, I consider it as too low, because every day, 48,000 people are died every day in India. That's the way it works. So we produce a lot, and it is not reaching the people. If you look at the fruits and vegetables, we produce in the country level, is about 318 million tons of fruits and vegetables are produced. We are second largest producer next to China. And fruits or vegetables that are produced by farmer, it is not reaching the consumer. Every three fruits produced, one fruit is lost because of the post-harvest losses. That's what I talked this morning as well. We have developed a fruit preservation formulation. It's called nano formulation. When the spray is given, the fruits are preserved for 2 weeks. And this can also be used for dipping. You see the Banganapalli mangoes, they are fresh when it is sprayed in the field, and it can be sown. It is very useful, particularly when demonetization was announced by Prime Minister somewhere in 2016 or so. And some farmer used this technology to preserve the fruits on the trees itself. It is very important, or it can be dipped. We have done extensive research in Dharmaburi, Krishnagiri, Salem, Dindukal, and Kanyakumari. Those are the districts we have done. And this is done in collaboration with some of the ADAs maybe involved, like Sanmugha Sundaram in horticulture, and some of the agriculture officers as well. They're all involved in this process. And we have done extensive experiment in Keni, where whatever the formulation which I'm referring, we kept the fruit for some 5 minutes, then fruits are preserved for 2 to 3 weeks. Surprisingly, we have tested four varieties of banana, Grand 9, Nendran, and Puvan, and Red Banana. The Nendran is a very important fruit, particularly for chips making. And the A1 chips, they make, Tamilians eat 30 tons of chips every day. That's the way A1 chips has the statistics. So this particular formulation keep the fruits fresh. So that is important for green banana, like Nendran banana. So they wanted to use the technology. They are using it now. And this is a very important technology. Simply tip the fruit in this particular solution, the fruits are fresh. And when you put the tip the fruit in the solution, always people are afraid of chemicals. Then we thought it can be used in a different format. Then I already explained about the nanofiber technology. Then this compound, a volatile compound, is all hexanol. They were loaded into this. I have the patented product now. So a small sticker like this, a fruit box of 3 kilos, you put a small sticker, it's enough to keep the fruit fresh for 2 to 3 weeks. The cost of the sticker is only 2 rupees. So that way we can preserve fruits, mangoes and banana. A small technology will help a lot in terms of processing the fruits and vegetables. So we also prepared a pellet that can also go into the box of fruit. Just to put the pellet inside the box, it is enough to keep them fresh for 2 to 3 weeks. And this technology is very powerful, and it can also, this is used very well. And we try to do sometime, you know, it's a COVID time, people are not taking the consignment. So when a big consignment of 60 tons of fruits from Delhi, it went to into Netherlands, and it stopped somewhere in the dock, and we could save the fruits effectively. So that way we can keep the fruit fresh for a long time. So we also developing small technology. It is like a mosquito liquidator. It is kept here. And now this technology is very powerful now, where if, this formulation is spread in a box container lorry, a small quantity of 100 ml. It's enough to keep the fruit fresh for 2 to 3 weeks. The cost would be only 100 to 200 rupees, but you keep the fruit 20 tons. So that type of technology we have got. So we have got nano sticker technology, nano pellet technology, nano vapor technology. We also have the formulation as a pre-hour spray as post for us dip. So the last technology which I want to say is the fiber, nano fiber technology, which is extracted from the banana pseudo stem. After banana fruit is harvested, you get the pseudo stem. The pseudo stem is about 80 tons per hectare, and you extract the fiber in our university, close to our university is Thondamuthur, where we extract the fiber. We convert them into nano cellulose and make the film like this. And this is highly useful. This film can be used for covering the fruits and vegetables. We can also carry back. That is our ultimate aim. So this is a biofilm, 100% degradable. Within 3 to 4 weeks, it degrades quickly. So we tested against tomato fruits. We cover the tomato fruits with the film. The fruits are preserved for 18 days without loss of fruit. So this technology is also very good. And I think that's the technology. The farmers are very happy with the nanotechnology. The last one is that any technology which ends up with safety, people are worried about the safety of the material what we use. So we need to make sure that the product which is developed, it is tested against microbes, tested against the predators, parasites. Honeybees are very good indicators of nanotechnology. Honeybees are the real indicator, because honeybees are very sensitive to contamination in the air. If there is some pollutant present in the atmosphere, honeybees won't come. Honeybees itself use nanotechnology for its own survival. Honey, when the honey is synthesized, one drop of honey, it's made of several, you know, it has to go to at least 1,000 flowers, 10,000 flowers to make one drop of honey. So that is called atomic manipulation. That's why honey is 100% preserved. That is why our forefathers or grandfathers and most of the medicines prepared in India all honey-based, because honey never degrades. If honey degrades, it is the fault of the individual who supplied, who adulterated it. So that's a problem. Ethom is another good indicator. Zebrafish can be used. So these are the tests we have to do before, say or declare that the nano products are safe to use in the society. As Raghuraman indicated, my growth is increasing faster. Even after, as a director of research, I maintain at least 5 externally funded projects worth over 5 crore. Now in 2020, I reached 35 crore. So lots of crores are coming. So just to indicate, though crores of money coming my way, the product which we refer to common people, it is affordable, accessible, and so on. So in honor of my invention, and I was given a NABARD chair in, it's 3 years now. It's a lifelong commitment that is a chairman, Dr. Banwala. He came to 2017 and declared that nanotechnology be recognized for a chair professor. I'm the chair professor for lifelong. Then I have a few publications in Nature, which is highest order. Only few people in TNAU published Nature, maybe Sudhakar and me so far in 100 years. And we have got several papers, books published, and I have 2 more books getting ready to be out very soon. So it's a very good laboratory. Certainly, I thought when I proposed this lecture to be delivered, I thought of taking you to this laboratory. This laboratory is a very transparent very glossy laboratory. I'm the founder head of this particular lab. So any corner you can see who is doing what. So that type of facility, it's a 20 crore facility. All the machines are assembled. We can do wonderful research in this particular facility. And thank you very much for the opportunity given. I have to thank all the funders who make me to come to this level. And thank you very much for the opportunity given. Any number of questions can be